Yo, guys, this is Talking Anime here, bringing you a Naruto manga chapter 629 review. Alright, this chapter started off by showing Madara and Naruto and everyone else on the battlefield. And basically, Madara hit everyone with a sort of attack with the Jubi, or should I say the Ten-Tailed Fox, yeah, not Ten-Tailed Fox, the Ten-Tailed Beast, yeah. And basically, Naruto protected everyone once again. But then now, Naruto's running low on chakra, so he can't protect everyone, and he can't even protect himself, let alone everyone. So, but Madara basically wants to finish Naruto and everyone else there off here, yeah, because yeah, he wants to go see Hashirama. We all know that from the last chapter, because he was smiling as f mad. And as I predicted on my prediction video, I said that Madara is probably going to end up going to find Hashirama and meeting him, yeah, either attacking him, greeting him, or getting something from him, yeah, such as some sort of DNA that only he knows about, yeah, which can embrace his power even more, or enhance his power even more, or even just bring him back to his normal self instead of him being in that either tensei form, just like an original body, his original body. But and yeah, so anyways, and then the chapter fast forwarded, guys, yeah, to basically Kakashi and Obito fighting in their basically dimension. And basically, Kakashi could have killed Obito many times, and I don't know why he didn't, or why he didn't injure Obito to the point, yeah, where he couldn't move or something, or where he was paralyzed. Because Obito even stated himself, "You could have killed me many times, but you chose not to. Why are you feeling guilt towards me?" And Kakashi then explains, yeah, to him, yeah, that you're questioning Naruto because you see yourself. He has the same ideals and visions as you, yeah, and you're questioning for there's a reason, because you can still, because you want to turn back yourself. Yeah, and then Kakashi basically explains to him that you can come back if you want to, just stop this foolishness. And then Obito then goes, starts laughing and says, "I know that you didn't kill Rin on purpose or something like that. I know everything." And then he basically explains it, what happened with Rin. And what it explains is that Kakashi, Rin, yeah, was stolen by a certain village, and they put one of the Jubis, yeah, inside of her, and then she was running back to the ninth, to the Hidden Leaf village. And what happened now is that they set her up so that once the beast is released, yeah, it would then wreak havoc inside of the Hidden Leaf village, which is just bad. So as Kakashi was gonna kill the pursuers, yeah, Rin jumped in the way and died for the village's sake, basically. And Obito knows this, knowing that Kakashi didn't really do it, but he's still not opening up his eyes. But guys, go and read the chapter yourself, see what you think about this. And yeah, this is Talking Anime.